Nifty PLC cash budget highlights a short-term surplus in the near future. Which of the following action would be appropriate to make use of the surplus? If you have short-term cash surplus, when you are making an investment using the short-term cash surplus, there are three things that you have to consider. So what are the three things? First one is the safety. So under the safety, what they are telling is, when you are making an investment using short-term cash surplus, there shouldn't be any capital losses. So let's take an example. If you purchase some shares, there is a chance where you can end up with not getting the amount that you have invested. So what they are telling is, using the short-term cash surplus, when you are making an investment, those investment shouldn't get you a loss in the capital. And second one is the liquidity. So what is this liquidity is, when you are using your short-term cash surplus to make an investment, you should be able to get the money when you need. So what they are simply telling is, using your short-term surpluses, you shouldn't do long-term investments like depositing in the bank for long-term, like purchasing shares, those things you shouldn't do. And third one, what you have to understand is, using your short-term cash surplus, when you are making an investment, the profitability should be there. So whatever the investment that you are investing, whatever the investment that you are making using your short-term cash surplus, should give you the better return. But there is a risk involved. You know, when you are getting a higher return, the higher the risk. But you have to understand what is the best option for you. You have to decide the best option. What is the safest one? What is the more profitable one? So based on that, you have to invest your short-term cash surpluses. So simply what you have to keep in your mind, when there are short-term cash surpluses, when you are making investment, you got to consider three things. What are the three things? First one is the safety. Second one is the liquidity. It shouldn't be long-term investment. Third one is the profitability. Now let's get into the question. Which of the following action would be appropriate to make use of the surplus? So let me start with option B. Investing in long-term deposits in bank account, it's a wrong option. I said you shouldn't make long-term investment using your short-term cash surpluses. Second one is increasing payables by delaying the payment to your suppliers. So if you delay the payment to your suppliers, if you increase the payables, what will happen? Your cash surplus will get increased further. That means you are not trying to use the surplus. You are trying to increase the surplus further. So that's a wrong option. Buy back the company shares. So if you buy back the company shares, is it short term? No. So that's one also wrong answer. So first one, A, pay suppliers earlier to take advantage of any prompt payment discount. Yes, if you have any short term cash surpluses, what you can do, you can make the payment to your suppliers in early and you can get the early payment discount. So that's a better way of managing your short term cash surpluses. So for this question, your answer should be A. Which of the following statement concerning working capital management are correct? Working capital should increase as sales increase. Yes, that's a correct statement. Normally, if you are expecting your sales to get increased, you have to increase the amount that you have invested in the working capital. If you didn't increase the amount that you have invested in the working capital, what will happen? It will lead to an overtrading. The company will try to do a huge thing using a little amount of working capital. Let's take an example. You have invested $1,000 in working capital. Currently, using this $1,000, you are working for the maximum efficiency. You are generating a sale of $10,000. This is the sales that you are generating from current working capital, which is 1,000. As a business strategy, what you are planning to do, you are planning to increase the sales by 10 times. Okay, so you are expecting a sale of $100,000. So if you increase the sales by 10 times, what you have to understand, you have to increase the amount that you have invested in the working capital also. If you try to manage this entire 100,000 using a working capital of 1,000, it is a problem actually for the business. That indicates that company is trying to do over trading. They are trying to do more than what they could do, because they know they don't have that much of amount, that much of cash to run the business, to generate a business of $100,000. The amount that they have invested in the inventory is not enough. The amount that they have invested in the receivable is not enough. You just think and see. Previous scenario, 1,000 is the working capital, that entire amount you have invested in inventory. So using $1,000 inventory, you are expecting a sale of 10,000. Now here what you are doing in second scenario, using the same $1,000 inventory, you are expecting to generate 100,000 sales. So it's practically not possible, right? So always you have to keep in your mind when it's come to the practical scenario also, if you are expecting to increase the sales of the business, you have to increase the amount which you have invested in the working capital. If not, it will lead to a overtrading. So first one is a correct statement. Working capital should increase when your sales increases. An increase in cash operating cycle will decrease the profitability, obviously. When your cash operating cycle increases, your profitability will get reduced. So let me take an example. You have an inventory days of 30 and you have a receivable days of 60 and you have a payable days, we'll assume it as 20. So you have a working capital cycle, we'll call it as operating cycle. So how many days are there? 30 plus 60, 90, 90 minus 20, it is 70 days, okay. So what is the meaning of the 70 days is you will run the business for this 70 days using your whatever the short term financing that you have obtained from, let's assume, bank loan or bank overdraft. So you will have to pay interest for this 70 days. Simply for you to understand, I can pitch it in this way. How many days that you have to run the business without having the cash? So you have to run the business without having the cash for 70 days. So for that 70 days, for your day-to-day work, for your working capital purpose, you have to get the money from the bank overdraft or bank loan. So you have to pay interest for 70 days. So you just think and see, if this 70 days increase to 150 days due to some reason, if your working capital cycle, if your operating cycle increase to 150 days, as I said you, for your understanding purpose, you have to run the business for 150 days without having the cash. That means you have to fund your working capital, whatever the money that you need for your day-to-day operation, you have to obtain it from a bank overdraft or short-term loan. So when you take the loan for 150 days, what will happen? Your interest will increase. If interest increases, the profitability will come down. So an increase in cash operating cycle will decrease the profitability. Yes, it's a correct statement. And next one, overtrading is also known as undercapitalization. Yes, that is correct statement. What is overtrading is you are trying to do more than what you could do. You have not invested required amount. You have not invested enough amount for your working capital. So amount that you have invested is not enough. It is undercapitalization. So what is the overcapitalization means? You have invested more than what you need to run the business. There is a certain amount that you need as working capital. Because you are risk averse, what you have done, you have invested lots of amount, you have kept lots of amount as your working capital. If you keep lots of amount as your working capital, from other end, what you are sacrificing the profitability. As your working capital, you have kept 100,000 inside your locker. That's a huge amount. Let's assume like that example. What you could do, rather than keeping 100,000 inside your locker, you can keep only 50,000, which is an efficient amount. A better amount, remaining 50,000 you can deposit in the bank. So if you deposit in the bank, you will get some profits, interest. So if you invest a huge amount in the working capital, if you keep huge amount as your working capital, from other in what you are sacrificing your profitability. So always there is a trade-off problem in this working capital. Liquidity versus profitability. If you try to increase the liquidity, the profitability will go down. If you try to increase the profitability, the liquidity will go down. So as a business, you should be able to manage these two properly. Okay, 100,000 I have. Out of that, how much I should keep for my working capital purpose? How much I should keep for my investment purposes? So that's how you have to manage your finance. So in this question, what they are telling is overtrading is known as undercapitalization. Yes, you have not invested the required amount for your working capital. That is undercapitalization. It is overtrading, correct? What is overcapitalization means? You have invested more than what you need. That is overcapitalization. So this is a correct statement. Overtrading, you are trying to do more than what you could do. You are trying to achieve using little amount of working capital. The amount that you have invested in the working capital is not enough. So it is undercapitalization. So it's a correct statement. So all three statements are correct in this question. So your answer for this question, it should be D. Which of the following might be associated with a shortening working capital cycle? So you know how to calculate the working capital cycle. If it is a buying and selling business, inventory days plus receivable days minus payable days is equal to working capital cycle, or we will call it as operating cycle. First one, lower net operating cash flows. So for you to understand, let me pitch it this in this way. If you are trying to reduce your operating cash flows, it indicates you are trying to increase your credit flows. So if your credit flows increases, what will happen? Your receivable days will go up. If this also go up, obviously your working capital cycle also will go up. Here they are asking the shortening the working capital. That means this answer should come down. It shouldn't go up. So that's a wrong statement. Second one, increasing the tax allowable depreciation expenditure. Depreciation and working capital cycle, it doesn't have any connection. So that statement also wrong. Next one, slower inventory turnover. Let me take an example like this. Before, the inventory turnover is 15 times. Now inventory turnover is 10 times. So what's the meaning of this 15 times is, those days for a year your inventory is becoming a sale 15 times for a year. Now your sales are becoming, your inventory is becoming a sales for a year only 10 times. So as an example, those days approximately your inventory to become a sale, it will take, I would say approximately, we'll assume there are only 300 days for a year, 20 days. Now your inventory to become a sale, it is taking how many days? 30 days. I assume only 300 days are there for a year. So those days your inventory is becoming 15 times a sale. That means once in 20 days it is becoming a sale. Now it's not like that. Now it's becoming a sale once in 30 days. Your inventory turnover has been reduced. So here, see what's happening to your inventory days, it is increasing. That means, you know, when your inventory days, this answer increases, again your working capital cycle will increase. But that's not they are asking. They are asking the shortening of the working capital cycle. So that one also wrong answer. Final one, taking longer to pay your supplier. Yes, that's a correct statement. You see, if your payable days increases, that means if your this negative value increases, what will happen to the final answer? The final answer will come down. So if final answer coming down means it is shortening the working capital cycle. So taking longer to pay your supply is the correct statement for this question. So your answer is D. The following information has been calculated for D company. What is the length of working capital cycle? So it's a production business. In a production business, how to calculate the working capital cycle? First of all, you will have the raw material days plus work in progress days plus finished good days, or we'll call it as inventory days, plus receivable days minus payable days is equal to the working capital cycle. So trade receivable collection period 10 weeks, so receivable days 10 weeks. Raw material turnover period is 6 weeks, raw material days 6 weeks. Work in progress period is 2 weeks. And trade payable days are 7 weeks. And finally finished good days or inventory days are how much? 6 weeks. So what's the working capital cycle that you are getting here? 6 plus 2 plus 6 plus 10 minus 7. You are getting 17 days. Your working capital cycle, sorry, it's not 17 days, 17 weeks. So it's there in answer C. A company sells inventory for cash to a customer at a selling price which is below the cost of inventory. How will this transaction affect the current ratio and the quick ratio immediately after the transaction? So let me do the calculation using certain numbers before the transaction. I'll do before. So I am telling you have certain current assets. Current assets are 1000, and inside this thousand you have an inventory. Okay, the value of the inventory is $200. Inside this 1000 current asset you have an inventory. The inventory value is 200, and you have certain current liabilities. I am telling current liability value is 500. Okay, so let's calculate the current ratio. You know, current assets divided by current liability. So current assets you have 1000, current liabilities you have 500, so you are getting a current ratio of 2. Let me calculate the quick ratio also. Current assets minus inventory divided by current liability. So current assets minus inventory, 1000 minus 200 divided by 500. So what's the answer that you are getting there? 800 divided by 500. 800 divided by 500, you are getting an answer of 1.6. So this is the quick ratio. You are getting an answer of 1.6. Okay. This is before. After. Now let me do it after. What they are telling? A company sells inventory for cash to a customer at a selling price which is below the cost of the inventory. Okay. So there is asset which has a value, sorry, there is inventory which has a cost of 200. I am going to sell this 200 worth inventory for $100. We'll assume like that. If that is the case, how it will affect my current ratio and the quick ratio? So current assets, I have 1000. Okay, I sold the inventory, so that inventory amount is getting reduced. But if I sell the inventory for 100, I will get cash now. So this will increase by another 100. So now how much is the current asset that I have? I have a current asset of 900. So same current liability, which is 500. So let me calculate the current ratio. Current assets divided by current liability. Current assets, now I have 900 divided by current liability 500. So how much am I getting there? 900 divided by 500, I am getting an answer of 1.8. Okay, let me calculate the quick ratio. Quick ratio, current assets minus inventory divided by current liability. So current assets are how much you have except for inventory. Now you don't have any inventory because you sold entire amount. So how much is the current assets that you have now? 900. 900 divided by current liability is how much you have? 500. So here how much you are getting? 1.8. So you can understand what's happening to your current ratio and the quick ratio. Current ratio from 2, it is getting reduced to 1.8. So current ratio is decreasing. Quick ratio, what's happening? Quick ratio from 1.62, it is increasing to 1.8. Quick ratio is increasing. So current ratio decreasing, quick ratio increasing. It is there in answer C. I have done a comprehensive revision for ACCA Financial Management FM or F9 syllabus for a very reasonable price. You can purchase this revision through the link available in the description. In this revision program, I have covered 120 plus MCQ type questions and 6 constructed questions. For each question, I have given you detailed answers and I have provided some additional learning as well. So I hope this revision program will be useful for you in order to pass your exam. If you like my video, don't forget to like it, share it, and make sure to subscribe my channel.